Hi, good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I hope you all are doing well this morning. Well, I don't know where you are joining us from, so from my own end, it's actually morning. So I will want to greet everyone that is on this call today. So before I start, I just want to set some ground rules, right? They are no more like rules, they are just modus operandi of how we are going to take today's training, right? So first, I would like to start with introduction. Please, you can do well to use the comment section on this YouTube handle to please introduce yourself, tell us where you are joining us from. What the type from Nigeria? So I don't know where you are joining. If you are from Nigeria, then it's all good morning, right? So please just tell us where you are joining us from. Introduce yourself, your name, and where you are joining us from. I'll be looking out for those responses in the comments section, right? So starting with me, my name is Johanna Ayuba. I'm a lead trainer with Impact Her. So I have two amazing ladies here with me today. First of all, I have Jane Francis. Jane Francis is going to be the moderator for today, right? So Jane, you are going to be seeing more of Jane in the comment section. So please feel free to just interact with Jane in the comment section. And don't forget to also introduce yourself if you are just joining us right now. So, and I have an amazing person at the back end of this transmission. Her name is Judith Lokoso, right? Judith is our broadcaster for today. She's going to ensure that we have a technical hitch-free broadcasting, right? So she's broadcasting this section. You won't be seeing Judith. She's at the back end of this broadcast, right? So thank you very much, everyone. If you are just joining us, please do well to introduce. I can see some people joining already. So it's actually time for this amazing. So just like I said earlier, I'm a lead trainer with Impacta. So basically, what Impacta do is try as much as possible to close the gap in data literacy for women businesses in Africa, right? So we try as much as possible to give you all the necessary training, mentorship, and support you need to scale out your business, especially in this aspect of COVID. So that is what we are going to do. So with support from Google, we are trying to make sure that we achieve this mandate, right? So please do well to introduce yourself. I can see some people joining. I have Kemi Mabel. She's joining from Nigeria. Thank you very much, Mabel, for joining. I have Oluwaseun. Oluwaseun, please, can you just tell us where you're joining us from? I have Yetunde. Thank you very much for joining, Yetunde. It's nice having you guys around, right? So I hope you are enjoying the weekend. So it's weekend already, so it's actually time for rest and also time for learning, time for strategy and all of that, so that our week ahead will be great, right? So thank you very much, everyone, for joining. Don't forget to do well to introduce yourself. I can see a lot of people joining already, so please do well to introduce yourself. Okay, Oluwaseun said, I'm joining from Abeokuta. Wow, that is amazing. So how is Abeokuta today? So I have Oluwatomisin Ajayi from Abeokuta, Ogun State. Oh, that is amazing. Temitope Ilasami joining from Abeokuta as well. Wow, we're having most of the Western Nigeria here on this call. So thank you very much. I have Fayomi Rukaya joining from Nigeria. Thank you very much, Fayomi. I have Odewumi. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone. Thank you all for joining. So please keep the introduction coming. I can see Felicia Umokoro joining from Abeokuta. Thank you very much, Felicia. I can see Bello Sukurat from Abeokuta. Thank you, everyone. So as the introduction keeps coming, I just want to introduce us to what we are going to be doing today. So today we are going to have an amazing session to actually learn, right? So what we are going to be looking at today is how to build your brand and sell online. A lot have been saying about digital space, a lot have been saying about social media, but one thing you need to know is you need proper guide as how to start, right? How to start, how to go about it, and all of that. So please do well to feel free, get your notepad, get your pen and paper to jot a lot, because we are going to be learning some amazing thing in the next 1 hour, right? So this section is just going to last for 1 hour. So please feel free to also leverage on the comment section in the course of this training to drop your question. If you have any, please do well to drop as much as you can. Jane will be helping me to answer some while I also take on some, right? So thank you very much for joining. I can see a lot of people coming in already, right? Wow. I can see Shola from Abeokuta. I can see Soleil Ayomi from Abeokuta. I can see Bola. I can see Abimbola. I can see Tumininu. Yes, so sorry if I pronounce the names wrong. Please forgive my tongue, right? So I can see Funke from Abeokuta. I can see Fayomi Rukayat. I can see Rebecca from Lagos. Wow, that is amazing, right? So I can see Oluwakemi and all of that. So thank you very much, everybody, for joining. I can see Fatimo Adisa from Abeokuta. So you guys are all welcome. So going straight to the agenda for today, right? Going straight to the so today we are going to be looking at three amazing agendas for this training, right? Three amazing and powerful agendas. So sit tight, and it's going to be an interactive section. So this section is going to be more like a question and answer section. So please feel free to respond. I'll be going to be asking a lot of questions, and I also expect questions from you, right? So that we can make it interactive. So number one agenda we are going to look at is how to establish your brand online. We are going to see what it means to establish yourself online for your business, for the kind of services you offer, and all of that. Then secondly, we are going to see what it means to develop your e-commerce offering. E-commerce has been the core front of this 21st century. A lot of things are happening around e-commerce. So we are going to see how you are going to develop your e-commerce offering, right? Then last but not the least, we are going to see how to leverage on social media to drive sales, right? Because social media is one of the most patronized application in the world right now, especially things like Facebook, Instagram, TikTok. And so we're going to see how you as a person, as a business owner, can also leverage on this platform to make sales for your business or your services, right? So before we go ahead, there is an opportunity being offered by Google. I want to introduce you guys to it's an amazing opportunity, actually. We call it the free one-on-one mentoring made available from Google. All you need to do is if you have a small business or you run a charity and you feel a need for someone to also mentor you, for someone to guide you, for someone to stand in as a support for you in your digital activities, you can request for a mentor and it's going to be assigned to you for free. All you need to do is just fill up the mentoring form, and which Jane will be providing for you in the comment section. So please feel free to fill up the form. And when you fill the form, you get contacted and you'll be assigned to a mentor. I can see a lot of people coming in the comment section. So guys, welcome. I can see Badebo Victoria from Abeokuta. I can see Ogunsaya Bukola. I can see Afusa Bisola. I can see Oluwa Damilola, also from Abeokuta. So you guys are all welcome. So please take note of this opportunity. Jane will be dropping the link for you in the comment section. For you in section, the link will be dropped in the comment section for you to fill in. So now going straight to the agenda for today. Before I start, I want to ask a simple question, and I want to see multiple responses already in the comment section. How do you currently market your business as a person, as a business owner, and all of that? So please, can you just use the comment section and tell me how do you currently market your business, right? I want to see a lot of responses. Okay, Jane, I think you actually have a wrong link. That should not be the link for the GDSA mentoring. So that would be for the resources, right? So the link will be dropped just shortly. So please, okay, I can see some responses coming in already. So I can see social media from Satope. Wow, that's so amazing. Satope say I use social media. I want to see a lot of responses already, right? How do you currently market your business? So tell me right now, how do you do it? Do you use word of mouth? Okay, Salama Folade say I use online and physical stores, right? Okay, Oluwatomisin said I use one-on-one interaction and also social media. Afope said I use true social media. That is amazing, guys. That is up. So keep the responses coming. We want to see enough of these responses, right? So okay, Hatticott Signature said I market through friends, social media, and referrals. That is so amazing. Apolani said I market through social media. So a lot of people are already leveraging on social media. So please, this is an opportunity for you to see how to better optimize those things, right? So Afola said I use WhatsApp status, physical stores, and the rest. So keep the responses coming, guys. I so much love the energy in the comment section. So now going straight to the first agenda for today, which is establishing your brand online, right? Want to see what it means to establish your brand. Now, what are these benefits that are brought to businesses by going online? There are a lot of benefit, and if you have ever experienced one, please just drop it in the comment section, right? What are these benefits that you have benefited from when you put your businesses online. I can see a lot of people say, Oluwakemi said, I use display in the shop. Polariwan said, I use social media, WhatsApp, Instagram. Temitope said, I sell my business on social media. Pilumi says, selling online through WhatsApp status. A lot of comments there. So please do well to write. So now for those of us that have already leveraged on this online platform, has there been any benefit so far from putting your businesses online? I want to get that experience from you, right? So now this is why businesses are actually going online or need to go online, right? It's so, so important for you to know that a lot of things are happening already, right? So there are over 1.79 billion people currently, right now, having their businesses online, right? Or have shopped online just last year alone. Over 1.79 billion people have shopped online. And out of this 1.79, 97% of these people learn more about these businesses online than anywhere else. Now, this is the scenario. A lot of people, billions of people have actually shopped online, right? And most of these people get to know about these businesses, not when they were passing on the main road, not when they were in the church, not when they are strolling, not when they are watching the news, but most of them, over 97% of them, actually knew about the business when they were online, right? Okay, so I have some amazing responses. Mary said, my businesses thrive more online. I meet new people online, especially on Instagram followers. That is from Omolala Janet. And I use all social media from Adiola. Thank you very much. It promotes my brand from Debo. So thank you very much for those amazing responses. So now we are trying to establish why you need to. So now, and out of these 1.79 billion people, 97% of these purchases will be through e-commerce by 2040. Now, what it means is, as the world is changing, we are already in 2022 already, a lot of activities are happening online. Transactions are happening, payments are happening, buying and selling of goods are actually happening online. And it has actually come to stay. So there is no way we as business people, we are not going to leverage on this. If you actually want to make money, if you actually want to make sales, then you need to leverage on this. On this opportunity to make sales. So that is why we encourage every business to be online. Now, how do people actually leverage on the internet these days? Number one, a lot of people leverage on the internet to sell their products, while others leverage on it to actually buy products. Others use it to advertise. And one key benefit of this platform is advertisement, right? When I'm you get to reach out to people, just your current location. You reach out to a lot of customers and all. Then lastly, you get to research your competition. I mean, researching your competition, business, we know that it's not just you who your business that is actually in the market. A lot of other people are actually doing the same thing, or a lot of people are actually selling the same kind of product. But for you to get an edge over your competitors, you need to learn more about them. You need to learn what they are doing. What more can you do so that you attract more customers to yourself? How to better package your product or your services and all of that. So that is what it means and all of that. So these are how businesses leverage on the internet. Now, going straight to what it means to build an online presence. Building an online presence comes in different forms, right? It comes in different forms. So it doesn't necessarily have to be just having a social media profile. It has to be with putting your business on different platforms that people are engaging with, right? Because let me tell you one thing about business that is so amazing. You actually have two types of customers, right? You actually have two types of customers. Number one type of customer are the intent-based customers. Intent-based customers in the sense that they are customers that are currently looking for you on their own. I just wake up in the morning and I feel like I want to buy a particular product or services. I go to Google, I begin to search, I go to Instagram, I begin to look for anybody that is selling, let's say, devices, or anybody that is selling makeup kits and all of that, especially for ladies. So those kind of customers, they are actually looking for you. They have not even seen your product, but because they have a need and a want for that particular product, they tend to go to various means platform online to begin to search for you, right? Then what I mean by the identity-based customer are those customers you tend to look for. You look for them so that you can market their product so that they can have interest in it. Customers that are actually going to be buying from you. So those kind of customers, you look for them. So now building an online presence has to do both two ways. You have to also position yourself online so that when those kind of people are looking for you, you get to also find them. And secondly, when you are looking for them, you also tend to find them. Now, let me give you an example of two particular platforms for social media, like Facebook and Instagram. If you are the one looking for customers, so you position yourself on this platform so that you begin to appear to these potential customers with your advertisement, with your posts, with your product. While if you are actually staying or in need of trying to attract those people that are looking for you, tend to open an online presence like a website. So that is one of the platforms for you to position your business. So building a website is actually also another important aspect of your business, right? Trying to get yourself a website so that when people go to Google and are searching for anything that has to do with your business will appear to them and they will take you as an option to buy from you or to even inquire more. Now, there are different platforms available for you to position your business. And it's actually totally fine to start with just one, right? Depends on whether you have budget or resources. So it's actually totally fine to start with one. So number one is you can build your own website. Building your own website means that you position yourself on Google. Anytime someone is searching anything that has to do with your business, you tend to appear. Just take for instance, when you go to Google, you are searching for something, a lot of options will appear. You see different websites, different blogs, and all of that with almost similar or the same information you're looking for. So that is how website tends to help your business, right? So you tend to appear on this platform. Then secondly, social media platform. Social media is actually an important platform as well, where you get to interact with a lot of people, especially on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat, and all of that. So social media is also an online platform that you can leverage on to position your business. Then thirdly, we have the online business directory. What you mean by an online business directory is just like an encyclopedia. It's just like a dictionary where you put your businesses based on the category it belongs to. So let me give you a simple example. When you are looking for a particular word in the dictionary, because the dictionaries are arranged alphabetically from A to Z, the moment you are looking for any word that starts with a C, you just directly swipe to where the C and you begin to narrow down your search. So the same thing online business directory is tend to categorize businesses based on the category. If you belong to telecommunication, if you belong to entertainment, if you belong to food and beverages, then you now list your business under that category. And a lot of people that are looking for you, the moment they go there, they will just narrow down their search and look for you. And it tends to show them your address, your contact information, and all of that. Then last but not the least, the e-commerce platform. E-commerce is an amazing platform. And a lot of us I know, directly or indirectly, we have actually engaged in this e-commerce platform. E-commerce platform is where we have the buying and selling directly from sellers, from vendors, and all of that. And we even tend to make payments. We tend to even collect, make payment for delivery. We tend to get our goods delivered to us. So e-commerce platform is an amazing platform. So e-commerce platform, if you're in Nigeria, things like Jumia, Konga, Jiji, and all of that. So those are the kind of platforms that are actually so amazing to us. And we need to also take note of. Now, this is why e-commerce is actually booming right now. E-commerce in Africa. So there's an amazing data that you need to focus on. There are over 400 million internet users in Africa, and we are just second to China, right? So China is just the leading internet user, followed by Africa. So it's going to tell you that a lot of people are actually online, right? The customers you are looking for on the street are actually now in your fingertips, just with your device, you can able to reach them. Then out of this 400 million, 10% of retail sales with an estimated value of over 75 billion naira will actually be made by 2025 in the next 3 years, right? So then over 16.5 billion worth of dollars was generated from e-commerce in 2017. So begin to imagine how much was it in 2018, how much was it in 2019, or even just last year, right? So we are in 2020. So this particular data has already skyrocketed. So this is what we need to focus on. This is what we need to also look out for as a business to be able to know that there's a lot of money and a lot of customers to attract. So now there are a lot of e-commerce platforms available online. So some of us, we might have come encountered with, or we might have even done one or two transactions on this platform. So we have things like the Amazon, things like the Konga, Jumia, especially if you're in Nigeria, a lot of you have actually seen Jumia or come across Konga. I know Amazon is a global e-commerce platform, but I know some people are actually making purchases on Amazon, right? So these are example of e-commerce platform we have available. Then we have online marketplaces where a lot of activities, and one of my favorite online marketplace is GG, right? Because GG, you even get the opportunity to even sell old stocks. You get to even recycle things that you are not in need of. You get to see buyers request for your old phone, anything that you want to sell that is actually refurbished and all of that. So we have the Kilo Mall, we have the Bido Buy, where you even get to even sell even recharge cards and all of that, right? So these are amazing platforms for you to leverage on. And one amazing thing about this e-commerce platform is you don't need to actually build one for yourself, right? As a business person, you can actually put your product or the kind of services you offer on this platform. All you need to do is to create a merchant page where you get to display your platform, and anytime you make a sales on this platform, you tend to get your money back after the e-commerce platform have taken their commission for leveraging on the platform, right? So it's actually interesting. You save yourself the stress. You just put the kind of product. So you see this e-commerce platform like the Konga and all, they are just simply warehouses. Konga or Jumia don't own any product on those platforms. They don't manufacture. They are not the owners of anything you buy on those platforms, right? They just created the platform for you. It's just a warehouse where businesses can come and deposit their goods, their services, and all of that. So they help the businesses to broadcast those things. And whenever you sell, they tend to just take a commission as their own payment from anything you sell. So these e-commerce platforms are actually built like that. So even you as a person, as a business person, you can actually put your product on this platform without having to build a new one for yourself. And when we're talking about the online business directory, we have the Yellow Pages of Africa is actually there. You can list your business for free. You don't actually need to pay anything, right? So you can use Africa Business Pages. That's where I tell you it's more like a business dictionary where businesses are categorized based on different categories. If you're under entertainment, if you're under food and beverages, if you're under telecommunication, you're under real estate and all of that. So you go and check the category, you create an account, fill in, then you select the category. So it will list your business under that category so that anytime someone is looking for you and they want to actually buy from you, they can just go directly to those categories without having to flip all through the pages of the website. So now, how can you create a simple business directly on the Africa Business Pages? So all you need to go to do is just go to their website directly, Africa Business Pages. And when you go there, you register your business details, tell them about your business, the name of your business, and most importantly, your contact details. How do you want people to contact you? Do you want people to call you directly? Do you want people to send you an email and all of, then you choose your business sector, which is very, very important. Like I tell you, it's just more like dictionary. It's categorizing businesses based on categories. So it's very important you put your sector, and a lot of options will even be available for you to choose from, right? Then last but not the least, you need to narrow down and tell people where you are located based on your country or your region, so that if somebody from Ghana is actually looking for a particular business in Ghana, he won't come across a Nigerian business, and after the conversation you now tell him you are in Nigeria, he might not want to actually buy from a long distance and all of that. So you need to also indicate your country and your region, which is very, very more important for you at that particular moment. Then we talked about the social media, and I know a lot of people are already leveraging on that, but there are so much more. Going to make an amazing sale on this platform. So all you need to do is just account, add your pictures, get yourself a username, and add your business details. And there are so much more to social media, especially in the aspect of content and advertisement, right? So then that we just spoke about, I'm going to be pausing here for question and all of. So please, if you have question, it's time for question from this first agenda that we talked about. I'll be seeing, I'm going to be looking out for that question, right? So please It's time for question. Please, if you have any question, you can do well to drop your question right now. Please, it's time for question, and I want to see a lot of questions already. So please do well to drop your question so that we are going to be taking some of them and all of that. So okay, let me be looking out for question right now. So okay. I can see one, the first question coming in from Adesewa Lawase. What's the website, please? So okay, website for Africa Business Pages is actually www.africa-business. So I'm going to be sharing that in the comment section. Jane will put that in the comment section for you to see. So the website will be put in the comment section by Jane just about now, so that you see the website how it is, right? So thank you very much for that question. Okay, Okundala said, but sometimes setting up e-commerce platform doesn't bring customers. It actually does. Why I said that is because you get to you save your stress, the stress of actually paying to advertise. Let's take for instance, you are not going to be setting up. Setting up, if you're going to set up an e-commerce platform for yourself, is actually going to be a difficult one because you need a lot of money to market it and all of that. So for you to save yourself, it's better you leverage on e-commerce platform that have already made the name. They have the budget capacity to advertise, like Jumia advertise the shoes. They retarget customers. They follow up with customers to buy. They use their own money to do those marketing because they know the only way they make money is when you make money, right? So that is why you don't need to stress yourself as a small business to even build your own e-commerce platform. So just leverage on things like Jumia and Konga. I have one from, okay, Oluwakemi say, how do I create an e-commerce platform? Creating your own e-commerce platform is actually going to be a lot of work. So you need to get a website developer, people that have the capacity to build website for you to do that, right? But like I said, I do advise if you are a small scale businesses and you don't have money to do that, you can just do well to just leverage on things like Jumia, Konga, and all of that, right? And so that you can. Okay. Oluwale said, how do I create my own website? Creating your own website is actually a beautiful thing. There are lots of other options. You can create a free website for yourself on Google, right? There's a platform called Google My Business. So if you sign up or register your business on Google My Business, there's a platform or there's a site where you get to create your own website, and you don't actually need to even have any technical skills of creating website. It's just a simple drag and drop, right? So there's this other part that we are going to be talking about how to create your website in the course of our training, and I know it's among your training schedule. So we'll tell you how to go about creating your own website. Okay, Oluwayemi said this is educational and informative. Thank you very much for that. Okay, I have all social media and advertise there. Thank you very much. How can I go about setting up my business on e-commerce? All right, so Bolarinwa, you can actually get setting up. So you go to like jumia.com, Konga, then register. When you click to register or sign up on those platforms, it will ask you signing up as a customer or you want to sign up as a merchant. Merchant means that you want to sign up as a business so that you can be able to sell your product on those business. So just fill up the form. They will ask you a lot of questions and all of that. So just fill it up and then you can start from there. And so who handles, okay, I have a question from Wumi. She said, who handles the logistic arm of the business when you use e-commerce platform channels? They handle it. The platform Konga, Jumia, they handle the logistics. One thing is, either you bring your goods to their warehouse and keep, or anytime there is an order, they will reach out to you immediately and ask you, okay, there is an order immediately. Can you bring that particular goods so that we ship it? You know, Jumia do fleet, do delivery for people, but they even get to pay, our customers get to pay for those. So they handle the logistics themselves. So I think I've talked about how do I create e-commerce? What am I supposed to do to create my own website? I think I talked about that as well. What are the process or steps to take in order to join an e-commerce platform? I just talked about that right now. So Horticulture, thank you very much. But do setting up an e-commerce website really bring sales? Yes, it does actually. Yes, it does. Right? Have not been having more customers. What can I do? Well, it depends on how you position your businesses. Where are your businesses positioned right now? So you need to just go through this training. I'm going to be talking on e-commerce in the next slide, right? How to set up your e-commerce, right? So just hold tight and get your pen and paper. Kafaya say educational and informative. Thank you very much for that. How do I join the online business directory? So I think the website for that should have been dropped in the comment section, right? There's a website for that in the comment section. So please, it will be dropped here in the comment for the Africa business pages. Jane will drop it in the comment section so that you can do well to actually see how to register for that. Right. So that is that. So thank you very much. You can do well to keep sending in your question, and we are going to be attending to them individually. So I just so much like so. Okay, Adini says, is it mandatory to take the goods to their warehouse before it gets delivered to the customer? No, it's not mandatory. You can have your goods right in your house, but the thing is, you just have to be going up. The moment there is an order within the 5 minutes, they will ask you to bring the goods to the warehouse so that they can repackage it, because they actually have to seal it, right? So you can actually, if you are not too far from their warehouse, you can be keeping your goods in your house and then be bringing it up anytime there is an order, right? Can service provider advertise on e-commerce website? Yes, you can advertise. If you go to GG, you see people, plumbers, even lawyers these days. Also, it was so funny to even see lawyers advertise their services on GG, right? So you can actually advertise the services you offer, whether laundry and all of that. So how do we get a mentoring form? Okay, it will be paste. I think Jane have posted that form, so I do well to just remind her to do that as well. How can we get started when we want to register for e-commerce platform? Like I said, if you go to this e-commerce platform, if you click on the register button, you want to sign up like Jumia Konga, it will ask you two questions, whether you are signing up as a customer or you want to sign up as a business, right? So just go for the business aspect so that you fill in the form, and if you ask a lot of questions about your business, the kind of product you have, then you begin to advertise with them, right? So now we are going to the next agenda. I know a lot of questions are available for me on e-commerce, so let's talk about e-commerce, developing your e-commerce offering, right? We're going to be talking about developing your e-commerce offering. So now this is the second agenda for today. Now, what does it mean to actually develop our e-commerce offering? Now, for those asking, how can I start? Sorry, excuse me. For those asking, how can I start? Now, for you to start your own e-commerce platform, there are a lot of steps you need to actually take, right? And the first step you need to take in developing your e-commerce is what we call, you need to pick a domain name. You need to pick a domain name. Picking a domain name has to do with selecting what your business identity will be online. Let me give you a simple example. Let's say for Konga, if you are looking for Konga, their website is konga.com, right? So the konga.com is what we mean by the domain name. That is their identity online. So even you as a business person, let's say I see, okay, Lady Fashion World, that is the name of your business, this particular business. So you want to pick a domain name. Your domain can be ladyfashionworld.com or .ng and all of that. So picking a domain name is very, very important, because that is the thing people use to identify you. Anytime someone wants to go to jumia.com, you just type jumia.com.ng and it takes you directly to the website. So that is how it is. So that is the first step you need to do in developing your e-commerce offering. Then secondly, when you pick the domain name, you have to secure it. Secure it means that you have to register it. You have to make it your own, because the world is actually a global marketplace. You cannot just say, because my business name is janefrancis.com, so automatically I should have that domain name or that identity online. No, you have to go and secure it. And there are companies or there are agencies in charge of doing that, right? All they do is you come and tell them what is the domain you are looking for. The moment you tell them, they will now tell you the price, and the price is not much really high. So we have platforms like GoDaddy. You can go to GoDaddy to secure a domain name, and you need to also make sure that it's even available, because you might think that nobody's using the business name, but you end up finding out that a business, particular business somewhere in the world, is using that name for himself. So you can go to Domain King, you can go to Bluehost, any of these platforms, the moment you go, they will ask you to search for the domain name. So that particular name you have in mind, you just search for it. If it's available, they will tell you that the name is available. So you can just proceed to make payment so that you can actually secure it to make it your own at that particular time, right? So that is how to go about securing a domain name. Then secondly, and most importantly, then you build your website. And since we are talking about e-commerce, e-commerce is not just any kind of website, right? It's actually a big website that has to do with displaying your products and all of that in the future. So you need to build your own website. And in this 21st century, a lot of processes, a lot of things have been made easier, a lot, especially for people that don't have the technical skills. Before, when we are told about website, website is something that you need to code, you need to type, write code and all of that. But now you can use platforms that can easily build you, or that you can use to easily build a website for yourself without having to pay someone to do it for you, right? And how do they do it? We have platforms like Wix.com, or you even go to Google site. So what it does is they have created a lot of websites in different categories, in different business areas. All you need to go is to look at those templates, which one suits, which one best represents your business at that particular time. Then you just select that particular template and begin to edit. All you need to do is just to click, you drag and drop, or you just shift to where you want it to be. So you begin to change the pictures on those website because they are template, begin to change the text, you change the business name, and you have your website for yourself, right? You have your website for yourself. So that is how to go about to do that. So that is how to post your website, or that is how to build your website without having the stress of actually building a website from the scratch. So you can utilize those templates. Like I said earlier, they are already pre-built templates. All you need to do is just take the one that best represents your business and be able to use and edit, right? Then the next one is to upload content. Content is very important because you cannot have a blank website where people will not see the product, like Konga and Jumia. The moment you go, you'll be seeing shoes, shirts, and a lot of other various things. So you begin to upload your content in terms of the pictures of the product or the services you offer and all of that. So you upload the content on those websites, and they are very easy to do, especially when it's pre-made templates that are already available. So all you need to do is just to select those pictures you have on your system or on your device and begin to upload them so that you have your website ready for you. Now, just having a website is not just alone. We have best practices to follow whenever you are developing. Whenever you are creating content for your website, you have to follow some global best practices that will ensure that you are actually going to make money from it. Now, how do I mean by best practices to developing your content, right? Now, number one is you need to prioritize your audience. Prioritizing your audience has to do with you need to know the people your business is serving, the people you are providing that services to, so that you create content that best represent them, right? This is where your content marketing skills and ability comes into play. You need to know that if you are selling product or services for women, you need to create content that best suits those women. You need to create content that women will find appealing, right? You don't just create anyhow content, right? If I'm a guy, you are creating food, a video, and I might not be interested, but women can be interested in how to cook, how to do makeup, and all of that. So a lot of people misunderstand how to create content. So you have to give priority to your audience. You need to create content based on what your audience needs. Then secondly, you need to research your competitors, which is very, very important part of every business. If you do not research your competitor and know what they are doing, you might not know how to actually compete very well in that space. You need to know what your competitors are, better compete. You need to know how to better compete so that you can actually be able to make money. Then last but not the least, since we are talking about website, you need to learn search engine optimization basis. And now let me just give you a simple explanation of what search engine optimization basis means. Search engine is simply modifying or creating content for your website so that anytime people are coming to Google to search for information, your website always tends to appear on that particular front page. Let me give you, for instance, many of us have gone to Google to search for one or two things. The moment you search, and it has to do with what you are searching for in the first place. You tend to clean it up or you tend to close the pages. A lot of people find it difficult to go to the next page. So now for you as a business, you need to ensure that anytime someone is searching for anything that has to do with your business tends to appear in the first page, because thousands of websites are already there, and they are all competing for that front page, right? So you need to learn search engine optimization, because that is the only thing that will push your website to the front page, right? Then now, in e-commerce, there are a lot of packages available that can ease stress for you as a business person. So, and we call most of these things plugins. Plugins are more like a pre-built application that you're just going to use, that is going to bring a lot of efficiency, is going to bring a lot of ease in your processes. Things like promotion and discount code tools. You know, let's say you are a business person. A lot of people I know are already interested in e-commerce. Let's say, for instance, you have over 1,000 goods, different shirts, different shoes you want to advertise on Konga. And they are in thousands. You cannot begin to follow maybe during Christmas period, during Easter, or Valentine is just around the corner. During Valentine, now you begin to say you want to do Valentine, say you want to give discount, right? So the moment you want to maybe give a discount, you cannot start following through this product one after the other and begin to put 30%. There is a software that will help you to just run this discount promo code across all your products. You just command it, okay, all the shoes I'm having in my catalog, run 10% discount. All the shirt I'm having in my catalog, run 20% discount. So these kind of plugins help you to do that without stress. Then easy to use checkout, especially for those that were paying online and all of that. Then even the search engine optimization, we have application that will telling you how your website is performing online, how many people are coming to you, how better to even optimize the website so that you can appear on the first page. Then we have email marketing integration. How many of us, anytime we go to buy things online or we sign up for form, immediately you see email coming to, they will say go and verify. Automation. So all this email marketing integration helps you to automate the process without having to start typing those emails individually, especially when you're having traffic coming. So you see, the moment you buy things from Konga, they send you an automatic email thanking you, or the moment you subscribe, they send you welcome email. And also, this is what we call email marketing integration. So, and there are a lot of applications that helps you to do that. Then multiple payment options. We know we are in an era that there are a lot of available options to make payment. Some want to do payment on delivery, some want to use their card, even the card at that particular point, you might make it multiple, if that Visa, MasterCard, or Vibe. And or people want to pay with PayPal, some even open option of even paying with cryptocurrency, right? So these are the kind of plugins that help you to achieve that for your e-commerce platform. Now, and where do you get to download these plugins? Where do you get to download this plugin, right? So the plugins, you can actually get them on WooCommerce. There's a platform we call WooCommerce. You can actually see them. You see a lot of those plugins and even more than I just listed. Then there is a second place where you can go, Easy Data Downloads. You can also see most of this plugin. Then lastly, but not the least, we see WP e-commerce, where you can also get most of these plugins. So that is how to go about it. Then there is one important aspect, especially for those looking out to build their own e-commerce website, or for those looking out to build a website for themselves. It's very, very important you know that in this era, a lot of people use mobile devices to log in, or social media, website, and all of that. So you need to make your website mobile friendly. And when I mean mobile friendly, so that the moment someone is trying to open your website, it will not take ages, it will not take years, it will not take months to load, right? And it will also be compatible with the size, the images, and all of that. So the speed and everything is very, very important for you to ensure that your website is mobile friendly. And why do we say that? Over 2.41 billion people already shop online worldwide just last year. Then 21 million of these online shoppers across Nigeria, South Africa, and also Kenya. Then 50% of these numbers shop more on their mobile phone than in store, right? So now this is why we say you need to make sure that your website is mobile friendly anytime, anywhere, right? Always make sure that you test that. And there is how we go about testing the speed of your website. We have a simple link that helps you to test the speed of your website. I think Jane will drop that in the comment section. So all you need to do is just impute your domain name. Remember, I explained what domain name means. So you put your domain name in the deal and just click on run. It will analyze your website and show you whether your website speed limit is good or bad. And even if it is bad, it will tell you what and what. It will tell you maybe the images you uploaded are quite heavy. You need to find lighter images or reduce the size of the images. It will tell you maybe the compatibility of your site is not working or there is a plugin that is going to be slowing down your website. It will tell you all the necessary recommendations you need to make your website friendly, so that the moment someone just carries his mobile phone and load, within second, your website will open. And we know how, as human beings, that process is so appealing to us every time we are online, right? So now I'll be pausing secondly here for questions, right? Please, if you have questions, you can do well to drop that. This is the second call for question. We just finished the second agenda. We are going to the last agenda for today's training, right? So I can see a lot of activities. I so much love the energy about this training. So please, if you have questions, you can do well to the question. Thank you very much, everyone that is helping me to actually moderate this section. And also thank you very much, Jane, for such an amazing conversation you're having with people all over there. So I have lot of things happening. So Rukaya says, wow, thank you for the organizers of this program. Thank you very much, Rukaya. We so much love that response. This is amazing and educational from Akinola Basirat. I can't hear the last word, sir. Okay, please, can you do well to remind me for that? Okay, Omoloya said, I can't get the third best practices. Okay, so sorry about that. I don't know that I'm actually, okay, it was about search engine optimization, right? Where I was talking how to better optimize your website so that you appear first on front pages anytime someone searches for you on Google. You know, people search Google and a lot of options tend to appear. If they don't see what they are looking for in the front page, they don't even care going to the next page. So businesses compete for that position. And for you to appear on that position, you need to do a lot of work. You need to create content that people are searching for, especially in terms of the keyword they use, right? So you need to also make your website friendly so that Google will help you in boosting the website to the front page anytime they are looking for you. Okay, so Sak, I don't hear the name of those websites clearly. Okay, about the website where you can get your e-commerce plugins, right? So I think I talk about WooCommerce. The first one is WooCommerce. The second one is Easy Data Downloads. Then the last but not the least is WP E-commerce. Those are the websites where you get to download those plugins and all of that. So thank you very much for the question. Please, you can keep Anita said, do we need to pay to get a domain name? Yes, you actually need to pay to get a domain name, right? But it's not that expensive. I think the cheapest you can get right now is almost like for like 500. If you're looking for things like .com.ng, it just depends on the extension, right? Things like .com.ng can even, I'm not 200% certain, but I know the last I checked is you can get even the .com.ng around 1,005, 1,002. It depends on the platform you are buying it from, right? So it's actually, you need to pay for it. E-commerce plugin, could you please write in the comment section? Okay, so please, Jane, if you can just list out those we also talked about WP e-commerce. So please, Jane, do well to type it for them in the comment section, right? So thank you very much for the question. So so if you have questions, please, you can do well to still drop them. We'll still try as much as possible to attend to them, right? Okay, so now we are going straight to the last agenda for today. So please, let's do well to just pay good attention to the last agenda for today, right? So now, what are we looking at for today? We have how to utilize social media to drive sales. How to utilize social media to drive sales. Utilizing social media to drive sales is all about the platforms we use already, but there are a lot of techniques to them, right? There are a lot of activities. Now, how can social media benefit your business? I know I asked this question earlier on, and I saw an amazing response from people I know. I see a lot of people give so much response. Now, what are the benefits of social media? Let me just outline just a few for you. Number one, social media helps you to generate more sales, right? Why we start with more sales? Because that is basically the aim of every business. You want to make money, you want to sell, you want to get to more customers and all of that. So social media helps you to do that actually, right? Then secondly, it adds value to your brand. Take for instance, those that are not on social media, take for instance, those that are not online, they don't tend to see the benefit. A lot of people will not take them as a serious business because they are not online and all of that. So the value social media gives to business is actually amazing, right? Especially when you have Facebook, Instagram account, you cannot start telling people, please follow me on my Facebook account, follow me on my Instagram account and all of that, right? So those are the kind of value it tends to give your business. Then thirdly, it improves your marketing. Marketing in the sense that social media helps you to know what your customers are saying about your businesses, what your customers are in need of, and all of that. So it improves your marketing. Then number four, build relationships and network. On social media, you get to meet other businesses. You get to meet your suppliers, your other businesses that you are also into the same. So you tend to build a lot of network. You can even form a marketplace where different businesses can come together and be posting different products and all of that. Then it helps you to stay competitive, right? Social media helps you to stay competitive, which is very, very much important for your business. So those are the kind of benefit. Now, how to set up a social media strategy. I know a lot of people already have social media platform, but one of the most important aspects for you to make money from this platform is knowing the right strategy to follow. Right strategy in the sense that you need to know how to go about it, right? So now I'm going to give you this basic five principle or these strategies that is going to help you a lot in your social. Number one is audience. You need to define your audience. You need to know who are your audience. Anytime you are doing businesses, take a paper, take a pen, record and say, okay, I'm selling shoes. Who are my audience? Why are they interested in shoes? Why are they interested? You write it down. Who or what influences them, right? What I mean by that is what let's say for instance, some I don't know the names of shoe. Let's say, okay, I know one like Zara. A lot of women go for Zara product. Why do they like Zara product? What influences them? Is it a celebrity? Do they like the name Zara as a celebrity? Do they like the name Zara as a brand? You need to know what influences them. Then when are they usually online? It's very, very important because if you don't know when your audience are online, you just end up posting pictures about your products, your businesses, and you'll not be seeing people commenting, you'll not be seeing people liking because you are posting it in the wrong time, right? Then you need to also know which social media do they use, right? Especially for ladies, there are a lot of ladies that are strictly just on Instagram. If your business is for ladies that is on Instagram, you cannot be creating Facebook page at that particular moment because you're actually going for the wrong platform. So you need to know which social media your audience are actually. So it's very, that is your number one strategy anytime you're about opening a social media account for your business, right? And you need to also put it the right way so that it will guide you and it will help you make informed decision. Secondly, you need to define your business goals. Defining your business goal has to do with what do you want to use that social media for? It's very, very important. What do you want to use that social media for? Some companies, some businesses open social media account to just give customer service. Let's take for instance, banks. They have Twitter handle. They don't use their Twitter handle more often to sell their product, but they use their Twitter handle to respond to complaints, to reply to trends and all of that, right? So you need to know what are you using those social media handle for. Is it to grow your brand awareness? Is it to generate more sales? Is it to get more people on your website or connect with influencers? So knowing your business goals will actually direct you to what or the kind of content and posts you need to be making on those social media. Then picking a platform is very, very important. Picking a platform, like I said, is very important. You need to know where your audience are, which platform are they. If your audience are on TikTok, there's no point in even creating an Instagram account. You need to open a TikTok account, know how it works, how to make posts on TikTok, how to create videos and all of that. So you need to know which platform. If you are into B2B, B2B means that you are a business and you are servicing other businesses. You need to know if you need to create a LinkedIn account and all of that. So it's very, very important you choose or pick a particular platform that will best represent your business. Then tone of your voice is very important. What do I mean by tone of? People need to identify you anytime they see you. Let me give you for instance, anytime you go around, anything you see, sometime when you see anything that has to do with Coca-Cola, from far, from near, you know it's Coca-Cola, because from their logo, from their color, and the way they even write, the way they show their images, they are always saying Coca-Cola, right? So even you as a business, you need to also define your own tone. You need to know what are your brand guidelines, what are the kind of colors strictly for your brand. Just if you go to Zenith Bank, if you go to UBA, you go to GT, they have unique colors and logo. They don't use any other thing that has to do with, that is not represented. Then you also need to know the tone of your voice, who and done, the style of images you use is very, very important, right? It's very, if you go for Coca-Cola, there's always this style of images they use, family setting, people smiling, people making exciting emotions and all of that. So that is how Coca-Cola style of images are. So even for you as a business person, you need to know what are your own tone of voice, right? Then last but not the least, you need to define success. And defining success has to do with getting to know whether you have achieved your strategy or not and all of that. So if you don't define your success, you will not know whether you are actually making progress or not, right? So it's very, very important you define your success. At the end of it, at the end of the day, have you grown in your traffic that you set as the goal of your business? Have you increased your brand awareness? Have you increased your followers and all of that? Or have you even made more sales from your social media so that you know whether you are making progress or not? And if you are not making progress, what were the lapses? What is the issue? How can I improve, right? So that you better strategize and all of that. So that is how to go about a successful social media strategy. So I know I asked this question earlier, so I wouldn't want to go back to the question, which social media platform does your business use? I saw a lot of responses, WhatsApp, Instagram. So sorry, there was a slight network hitch from my own end. You know the way network work in this country, you cannot predict, right? So sorry about that. So like I was saying earlier, I'm coming. Let me bring up my slide again so that we can proceed, right? So I was telling us Twitter, and I was also congratulating us, all those that are in Nigeria, about Twitter ban and lift, right? So Twitter has been lifted and things are back to normal. So thank God for that. So Twitter is just a quick fire tool where you get to leverage on, draw conversation, follow trends, respond to customers. And proceed, right? So I was in Twitter, so I'm getting back to that place right now. Okay. So we are almost there, right? So we are just trying to round up actually. So after Twitter, we have Facebook. Now, wow, it seems okay, so pending, I'm just waiting for it to come up. So the next one is actually Facebook, and we know Facebook, how Facebook has been helping us to do a lot of things, how Facebook has actually helped us to reach out to more customers, more people, and all of that. So all these platforms are actually amazing. So we know Facebook and how Facebook has been able to help us interact. We create a business profile on Facebook, put our opening hours, our contact information, and all of that. So Facebook is also one of these amazing platforms that helps us to do that. Then we have Instagram. I so much love Instagram, especially for the ladies, right? For the ladies, they love Instagram so much. They love Instagram so much, especially when it has to do with posting pictures, images, and all of that. So Instagram has actually been an amazing platform. So that is, then last but not the least, we have LinkedIn, right? LinkedIn is a platform where we get to showcase our professional profile. Companies use it for recruitment and also to interact with other businesses and all of that. So these are all the platforms made available for us to leverage on. So these are all what we can leverage on. But most importantly, if you are going to take anything from this last agenda we talk, is the social media strategy that you're going to work with. So this is the best strategy for you to use in driving sales for your business. So this is this for the end. We have come actually to the end of today's topic. So before we go, I also want to make a reminder, if you need that one-on-one mentoring from Google, you need that one-on-one mentoring from Google, the link will also be dropped in the comment section. Please do well to also sign up for the form. They will get in contact with you and all of that. Then lastly, also, we have our social media handle, posting them already. We have for Google, you go to Facebook. If you're on Facebook, please, you can do well to also follow us on Facebook. If you're on Instagram, you can also do well to follow us on Instagram. And the links are there in the comment section already. If you are on Twitter, you can also follow Digital Skills for Africa on Twitter and all of that. Then we have that of Impactor as well. Then attendance is very, very important. Please, for those that are still here, please make sure you fill get your certificate ready, right? So that it will be sent directly to you. So please ensure you put in your accurate details so that we can do well to forward it to you, right? So attendance is very, very important. Then that is it for the this. If you have any question, please do well to also reach out to us on our social media handles, and we'll do well to try as much as possible to respond to you on that. So thank you very much for your time, and so sorry for the network challenge that we have been having, but I think we have actually done justice to most of coming trainings and all of that. So thank you very much, and we'll see you on our next subsequent trainings, right? So we have a lot of other trainings that will also reach out to you and all of that. So thank you, and have a lovely weekend ahead.